Oh, look at that. What's up, guys? I'm just getting everything kind of situated with this streaming software, so just hang with me. We got about 30 minutes till we're starting.
Oh, there it is.
Huh? Hey, party people.
I can see Twitch and the chat in Twitch.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
I can see YouTube and the chat in YouTube.
Nice.
And Nikki Talks Food, Facebook, and the chat in
Facebook.
Who's the best wife? I'm the best.
You're the best wife.
Who's the best wife?
You're the best wife.
Who's the best wife?
You're the best wife.
You have to say that because you're on camera.
How about
This one, that one has a delay. Oh, you're making yourself a little cocktail, huh?
Is this okay?
Cocktail.
Can I shake this without it flying anywhere?
Flip it over. There you go. I do that way. Jelly jar ready. Song on because you know it fires me up. Thursday, baby.
Their troubles away.
We can party all week long.
That was a dirty trick.
Muted. Your video is partially muted.
Oh, come on.
I told you.
Just some warm-up music, man.
Come on. Okay, we can delete it. Start over. Okay, good. We got muted for a minute because we put some warm-up music on, and well, we're gonna start in 7 minutes.
Did I start over?
No. I don't know if I can do that. But it looked like it's still...
Thursdays we wear black.
We do. On Thursdays we wear black. Oliver barks at us. And that's how it goes. Let's give him a bone.
Come here, puppy. It's time for you to enjoy a bone.
Go away.
We are starting in 4 minutes. There you go. And you're gonna get the whole job to look out too.
We got closed captioning on too, man.
Oh wow.
So Ultra V420 said, find something in the public domain. Can I interest you in some Bach? Classical music nerd joke.
Yeah.
I like you. Who's this? Ultra V420, who are you?
Who are you?
Who are you?
Show yourself.
Reveal yourself.
We got busted for putting some music on, so.
Just a little we'll Lionel Richie.
We'll just have to do original compositions only.
We do have an original Nikki Talks Food song.
We do. The original Nikki Talks Food theme song. Jen composed it on our little piano. Maybe I'll do a throwback intro to this week's YouTube video that will be out Friday.
What's it on?
Nikki Talks Food on YouTube. Oh, the
dummy.
The subject.
Yes, the
subject is jackfruit. I made chick-un nuggets from jackfruit. It's delicious, crispy, yummy, fresh jackfruit. Unbelievable.
I'm about to say big potatoes.
Big potatoes. The biggest.
Potatoes, yeah.
The biggest. Believe me, no one's ever seen bigger potatoes. So we got the angles though.
Yeah.
Give us a shout if you like the two. Whoops! just dropped the whole camera. Oops. There it goes. Give us a shout if you like the whole two angle deal, where you can see, you'll be able to see my cutting board and my pots and pans and stuff like that, and then also me. From the front, so yeah, let us know if you like it. Let us, actually that's Basil, know if you like it.
Ultra V420 said, you know me, Chef Nikki.
Oh,
also try some Todd Rundgren.
I bet Rundgren?
Rundgren?
Oh, Violet!
I bet he'd appreciate the attention.
Oh girl, I know you, Violet. I can't believe you're watching. That's so awesome. Thank you for watching.
On our YouTube channel, I know.
Yeah, that's cool. So, should we start? Okay, we got a couple minutes, but, all right, guys. So, I am Chef Nikki. This is our first week post-meal kit. We were doing these meal kits with Red Eye Coffee, and now we are basically... I want the whole world to cook with me. So I put out an ingredient list and I put out recipes and equipment list on Mondays, and then you cook with me on Thursdays. It's interactive. I'm streaming on 3 platforms, Facebook, YouTube, and Twitch, which is like new for me because I'm a Gen Xer. I don't know nothing about no Twitch, so I had to learn. So anyway, we got a new camera set up. We were using new software. We got a new wireless router to make your viewing experience better. So give us a shout. Let us know if you like it better. Let us know if it sounds weird so we can fix it. But that's basically it. So today we're making a steak beurre rouge. I'm using flat iron steaks, which is the top of the chuck blade at the top of the shoulder of the cow. You can use whatever steak you like. Some people are using New York strips. Everybody was asking me how thick they should be, and I said, you know what? As thick as you want, because the world is your oyster. This is your dinner, and if you want them super thick, you just cook them longer. That's all. Or maybe you don't. I don't know. Maybe you like it black and blue or Pittsburgh style. So we're also doing roasted potato wedges and a nice tomato salad. So the steak beurre rouge is, there's two sauces. They're sisters. So beurre rouge is with red wine. Beurre blanc is with white wine, and you use the red for meats usually and the white for fish. So you could use this exact recipe and sub out fish and white wine for red wine, and you'll have a beurre blanc. So the technique stays the same though, and that's why I teach culinary fundamentals. So I'm gonna show you exactly how I would teach it in a culinary class, and then you take that fundamental and use it later. So I'm drinking, have a little cocktail here, pineapple juice, black cherry club soda, and a little vodka. Delicious. So if you guys have seen my live streams before, you'll know that I always say you're going to make your starch first. So we're going to preheat the oven to 425. And that's, I got to press start. And we're going to start cutting up our potatoes. So I have four potatoes here, and I'm gonna start cutting them into wedges because we want our potatoes in the oven as soon as possible because the thing that takes the longest amount of time is always the starch. So we always start starch first. If I was making rice, I would start with the rice. You know, if that was my starch for my dinner, I would start with rice. If I was making, pasta, start with the pasta first. So that's kind of how it rolls, because it always takes the longest. So we're gonna cut, can you guys see that? In like little wedges here.
I see. Kind of
like a thick French fry. Okay, go ahead.
So everybody said hi, and everybody loves the two camera view.
All right.
Everybody thinks you're super fancy.
Super fancy.
Rhonda said, I rushed home from mom and dad's to be here.
Oh, thank you, Rhonda.
Rhonda's the best. Jimmy says, we are here. Hey, Jimmy.
And hey, Jimmy.
The Griffith family. Nikki says, steak. Hey, Nikki. Rhonda says she'll be using top sirloin. That's what we had on hand.
Yeah, cool. I recommend that for sure.
Jimmy says, what's the temp?
On the oven?
Yes.
425.
Ultra V says, I'm loving your large kitchen. Nice with the two angles. When you have duck or pork, can you take it in either direction?
When you what?
Have duck or pork, can you take it in
For the sauce? If you were doing pork, yeah, you could take it in either direction. Duck, I don't know. This might not be. I would do white if it was duck. I would do the beurre blanc. So check these out. We got some wedges, but they're kind of skinny. You see, I'm not leaving them super chunky. They're kind of skinny so that they get crispy on the edges. And I'm just chucking them into a bowl. Oops. Just chucking them into a bowl so I can toss them around. Almost the weekend, guys. So, how's everybody's week been? give us a shout if you're cooking along. We had a lot of interest in cooking along. Also, if there's something you want to learn how to make, let me know. We can make it. I thought about things like maybe some sushi. Maybe a couple times instead of making dinner, we'll do something like, homemade fresh cheese. So you guys we can live stream making fresh cheese, like a mozzarella or something like that. So give me your thoughts. Let me know what you guys are thinking.
Tallahassee Foodie started a watch party on
Oh, neat.
Our feed. Thanks, Jennifer and Leo.
Thank you, Jennifer. We did start this a half hour early so that we could have time to work out any, you know, tech kinks. So just know that if you start the watch party, I don't know if it's going to start from the beginning, and then, you know, people will be like, what's this half an hour of this lady?
Yeah, it's probably a lot.
It might be. I don't know. I don't know how that works. I'm not very techie. Maybe Jennifer would know.
Hey, Stacey. Stacey says, hi, Nikki and Jen. Emily is cooking with me.
Awesome. So we're doing the garlic. I got a gigantic garlic clove. I mean, this is probably like, you know, it's one clove, but it's really like three or four. So I'm just going to do this one. But I smash it like that, and then I crush it and make a paste.
Christine says she's cooking along with you.
Awesome.
Robbie says comfort food or Caribbean food. And Nikki says, yes, please teach us how to make cheese.
They want to make cheese. Okay, cool. We could do that.
My Shred World says, I've been craving this meal since yesterday. We are pumped over here.
What's it? Well, my Shred World?
My Shred World.
All right. Yeah. My Shred World, where are you? Let us know.
Oh, it's Meredith and Liam.
Oh, Meredith and Liam. Hi. Today is Thursday.
I didn't recognize you. Okay, and also he says, we need to spatchcock a bird, or better yet, birds. Chicken, turkey.
Oh, okay.
You get to do some spatchcocking.
Ultra V, we did a spatchcock a couple weeks ago, didn't we, for a meal kit?
We did, but we could do it again.
You can take a look at our older Nikki Talks Food Live meal kits. And
yeah.
I believe we did a chicken
spatchcock. We did do a chicken spatchcock with tomato pies and a red eye iced tea. Red eye blackberry sage iced tea.
Yeah. Okay, so Elizabeth says, really appreciate the meal kits and Max's delivery. Had to wash veggies and pre-measure everything tonight and shop it.
Yeah, sorry, Liz. All right, I'm going to chop up some parsley. This is just, you know, for pretty. If you don't have it, it's okay.
Jesse seconds Caribbean food, and Liz says, how much garlic?
Three cloves, Liz. So what are the suggestions? Caribbean, and what was the other one?
Cheese, the spatchcock, and something else.
Just putting it in this bowl like this. Caribbean. So I mean, that's a
comfort.
quite a broad, like, category.
Ooh, Jesse has a good idea. How about abuelas, black beans, and some traditional Cuban?
I can throw down some Cuban, baby. Okay, so Parmesan cheese. You know, I gave a measurement in the recipe, but to be honest, you just want to coat the potatoes. So, you know, give them a nice coat. I'll look at the recipe real quick, see what we got.
My Shred World said, what about seafood for summer?
Ooh, seafood too. I was thinking about seafood next, actually next week I'm going to take off, but I was thinking about seafood the following week. All right, quarter cup of parsley, quarter cup of Parmesan cheese. We're going to do a tablespoon of pro seasoning. I'm going to just kind of give it a coating like that. And then we are going to drizzle with olive oil. I love this bottle. It makes me so happy because it's so bright and cheery. And now we're going to toss them around. This is the fun part. Liam, you like to do this, bud. This sounds like it's right up your alley.
Ron is down for any of the suggestions.
Yeah.
Cuban or seafood.
Cuban food is delicious. Ooh, I smell the olive oil and the garlic.
Yeah.
Cheese. Check that out. Okay, they're like big steak fries.
Liam's on it.
And now we're gonna put it on a parchment sheet lined sheet tray. Got some garlic and stuff in there, wanna get it all.
All right, we got Vicky Too Good coming in hot.
Vicky Too Good!
Hi, Vicky.
Coming in hot, baby.
Rhonda said she's happy with anything but watermelon recipes.
What? You don't like watermelon?
Scott Ferris joined.
Hey, Scott.
Hi, brother.
Ooh, I smell the garlic, the olive oil. Ooh, this is gonna be delicious. So check out these taters, and these are ready to go into the oven. We'll probably bake them for about a half hour, maybe 45 minutes. We want them. I like them nice and crispy. I'm like really into texture. I like caramelization. So these guys are going in. So if you guys are good with that, I'm gonna go ahead and put these in. There they go.
Goodbye.
Okay, that was easy.
Yeah, that was really easy. I felt like you did that really quick.
Okay, I could slow down. Give me a 1 if you want me to slow down. Give me a 2 if you want me to keep on rolling. Because we're going to do the steaks next. Actually, you know what? We could probably just chop up our vegetables and stuff. Do a little bit of mise en place. Okay. I'm going to chop up some shallots.
Liz says 1.
1. Slow down, right? Okay, we'll slow down, Liz. Don't worry.
I felt like that was fast.
That was fast? Sorry.
I felt it. Jimmy says 1.
1. Slowing down.
Melinda says 1.
Slowing down, loves. No worries.
So maybe recap?
Okay, to recap. We just made the potato recipe, and I posted the recipes earlier in the week. You can check out my Facebook page for the potato recipe, but basically it was 4 potatoes. We cut them into big fat wedges, a quarter cup of chopped parsley, 3 garlic cloves minced, quarter cup of Parmesan cheese. It could be grated or it could be shredded. I just happen to have shredded in my fridge. A tablespoon of Pro seasoning, and then we tossed it all around, put it into a 425 degree oven, and they are baking happily away in the oven. And the next thing we're gonna do is keep on chopping up vegetables. So when we're done with our vegetables, you know, we can use this board for other stuff. So that's called mise en place.
Do we get to the shallot yet?
We're on the shallot right now.
Oh, okay.
Stacey, you guys ready for shallots? Give me a 1 if you're ready for shallots.
La petite pâtissière joined.
Ah, hello.
Liam says he's starving. 2-2-2.
Liam needed a charcuterie board to get ready.
Hey, you need an app, man.
You need an app, dude. Alright, we're gonna start chopping up these shallots, and the difference between an onion and a shallot is, I mean, it's just very subtle, but the shallot is kind of a more, almost like a garlicky taste, and they're higher in sugar, so they're just a little bit more, you ready for this? Nuanced. They have a little bit more nuance.
$5 word?
It's a $5 word.
Yes, we're peeling shallots, Stacey. Stacey, do I peel the shallot?
Peel the shallot! Looks like a little baby onion. They're kind of wonky shaped, you know. Go ahead and peel them. I'll do about 3 here. So we're gonna peel these shallots. And if you taste these side by side next to like a red onion, you definitely can tell the difference.
Oh, yeah.
But if you can't get a hold of them, you could always sub out a red onion. But you know, ideally, we want to go for the shallot. They're just so nuanced and sweet and depth of flavor.
Now you're just making words.
And yes. And they have super, super thin layers, man. They're just like weird little baby onions.
Ultra V said they break down so beautifully when cut, even when they're not heated.
They do. They break down. They melt into sauces. You know, when you mince them, they melt into the sauce. A lot of French cuisine, like this is a French sauce, the beurre rouge, and they always use shallots instead of just a regular onion.
Hey, Alex is here.
Alex, what's up, buddy?
She said, wish I was cooking with you tonight, but I'm in bed with a major toothache. What's on the menu for next week? I need something to look forward to.
I don't know. We were just talking about that. We're thinking about fish. What do you guys think about fish?
Didn't you say you were going to take off next
week? Oh, sorry. Next week I'm taking off. I figured next week everybody's, some people are leaving out of town, and it's like 4th of July week. And so I figure it's a good day for me to kind of like regroup, but I'll be back the following week. And so what's that, like the 14th? No, 7th, I think. 8th? 9th? Something like that. It's like the 9th or something.
So next Thursday is the 2nd, and then Thursday after that is the 9th.
Yeah, so the 9th. So I'll be back the 9th, so we should make a menu for the 9th. I was thinking fish. What do you guys think? Give me your thoughts.
My Shred World said, what about your shrimp ceviche?
That might have been... I can make a lovely shrimp ceviche. We could do that if you want, with shrimp ceviche. And that might not have been me. That might have been a different chef at Brown's. That's okay. I'll let it slide. That's okay. So we're just going to... Small dice these onions, or shallots. And I mean, really, if you rough chop them, it's not a big deal. I'll go ahead and do them all. Is this the right angle? Can you guys see this? Whoops, let me not do that thing again.
I can see you chopping.
You can?
Yeah.
Okay, great.
Alex says, I get to look forward to a root canal consultation next week.
Oh, how fun, Alex.
I don't usually eat fish, but would try something mild.
So maybe shrimp. Maybe we could do it. That's like the beginner. I usually do. When I do fish, I usually like to do a snapper or grouper, you know, like a Florida fish. Nothing crazy. I do make a really good salmon. But salmon is sometimes a hard sell.
Culture B said, salmon is always lovely and you can't go wrong with shrimp.
There you go. Shrimp is like the ultimate, you know, go-to seafood dish.
Yeah.
Get a little bowl.
Vicky said shrimp sounds good to her too.
Shrimp?
Yeah.
Like shrimp and grits?
It's like the introductory fish.
Yeah,
you know?
For sure. Shrimp and grits? You can do shrimp and grits with some nice, beautiful, bumpy road grits.
Nice Shred World.
Or whatever you got in your pantry. Doesn't matter.
Grouper.
Grouper's good. Yeah, maybe we'll do shrimp and grits. What do you guys think? Give me number one if you want shrimp and grits on the 9th, the week after next. Okay. So we got that done. The only thing we really have to cut up now is, we can cut our tomatoes and do our basil and stuff. So we'll go ahead and cut our tomatoes. Get a little paring knife. So I'm just gonna take a knife, put my thumb right on the, can you guys see that? Wait for this to catch up. Put my thumb right on the edge here, and then I just kind of poke in on an angle. And some people have, you know, that little tomato shark. It looks, has got like teeth. You can pull the core out real easy, but I just use a knife. So there it goes.
Got some ones for shrimp and grits.
Shrimp and grits, let's do that.
Yeah.
Shrimp and grits, that's a favorite for everybody.
We said Gouda grits.
Gouda grits, baby. And now, when you slice tomato, you want to use the entire blade so that you don't mangle the tomato. So we start at the heel of the blade, just draw it through so it drops down just like that. Yeah, Oliver doing his thing, doing his Oliver thing. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Okay, set those all up. I have some Kamado tomatoes that I wanted to show you guys. You know, they're just like these dark, like brandy wine looking tomatoes. So I have this little trick that when I do tomatoes like this shape, this grape tomato, I'll take my hand and just kind of go across here like that. That way they roll open like this on the plate and you don't see that little nub, that little root nub where the stem was. They just open up like that and they just roll around perfectly like that. So just wanted to show you guys that little technique. Diagonal on a bias is how you do it. It's on a bias. Just let them lick the whole jar.
Don't worry, I got it.
Okay. Licky. That's done. Tomatoes are done. How are we feeling? We feel great?
We're feeling good.
Feel great!
Let's see. Everybody is excited about shrimp grits.
Okay, all right.
Alex says she really loves the double angle.
Oh, cool. It took wizardry. Wizardry! Wizardry to do this. Good
okay.
Gravy.
Okay, boomer.
Yeah, really. All right, we're on to our basil next. Should I wait? Are we still chopping tomatoes? I could wait. I'm gonna wait.
Yeah, we should wait.
Do we can wait. Recap. So what we're doing right now is we're just cutting up our vegetables and stuff. That way all my veggies are cut up at once, and then I can use this board to rest my steaks on. So that's a little trick so that you don't do so many dishes, right? If I go back and forth, then I'm constantly washing. So I usually start with veggies, what's called mise en place, things in place, get everything all chopped up, and then this board can now have meat on it. So it's not, you know, like I have to wash it and all that stuff.
Push your board a little bit more towards the plate there so you get a better angle.
Well, let me push this thing.
Or, yeah, either or.
Either or. How's that? Can't tell. Oh, there it goes.
Gotta wait.
Gotta wait till it. We're on a delay in case we say the F word. Just kidding.
Ayla no, here. Just...
Hey, Haley.
Ayla.
Ayla. Hi, Ayla. Okay.
Yeah, that's good.
That's good? Uh-huh. Great. Yeah, it's, I had to, I'm not a techie person, and technology has surpassed me. Like, I have stayed in the early 2000s, and it has, like, I mean, I do okay with my phone and stuff, but when it comes to streaming, like, first of all, I think that we're in the early stages of like, you know, mastering streaming or making it, like, you know, so that it's easy to do. The software is crazy. It's like hit or miss, and you have to have like a coding kind of mind. Like, you have to be like, oh, I put the code in here and I do this. And so I had to do two. Originally I was using this one software and it kept crashing last, you know, couple weeks ago. So I had to do away with it and it just went to streaming on my phone. And then I did some research and I really worked on it this week, and I had to download two things: software and a software helper. Okay, so it's two things running at the same time, and I guess they work in concert together, and that's how we're able to get this done. So I don't know.
Jimmy wants you to show him the tomato thing again.
Which can. One? The which one?
No, he's just saying the tomato thing.
The tomato for the core?
Maybe.
Or the tomato, the little Kamado tomatoes that we cut on a bias. Let us know, Jimmy.
Alex says, you blow me away, you definitely make it look easy.
The technology part?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's real hard. It's real hard. I have to use my thinking brain, and it's also very expensive. I've had to like upgrade all this stuff.
Who Alter V's reading you? She said, you sure that you're a Gen Xer or are you talking like a boomer?
Girl, I know. I know, I'm aware. Like, I'm super aware. Like, it's just not my thing, you know?
Jimmy said the cut. He wants a tutorial on the cutting.
Okay, well, I'm assuming you want the little grape tomatoes, so I'm gonna grab some more out of the fridgey poo here.
Where'd they go?
Mm-mm-mm. so the brown tomatoes, the little kumatos. Let me give these a little rinse.
Kumato.
Kumato.
I didn't know that.
These are good. They're super sweet. They're super dark, you know. So Jimmy, to make them stand on the plate like that, you take, you know, it's like an oval. You just grab it and you go on it. You go diagonal. And you run your knife through, and then they just kind of split apart, and then they roll around, and you never see the stem when it's on the plate. It looks really pretty always. I learned that in yachting. My mentor, Barry Orr, taught me that.
You mean as a chef
on a yacht? As a chef on a yacht. Not as a guest. Always a bridesmaid, never a bride. All right, we're gonna chiffonade some basil, okay? This is the topping for our salad, and I wanna show you this knife cut. It's called chiffonade. You do it to leafy greens. Basil is one of the easiest things to chiffonade, so check it out. I'll do a little bit, and then I'll do it again. That way you guys can see it again. But basically, you take your basil leaves, and you stack them on top of each other like that. Then you roll it like a cigar. And then you chop. And this is called chiffonade. It's for leafy greens. And the reason why we like this is because it turns into ribbons. So pretty. So pretty. It stands up on the plate. It looks nicer, gives you good plate coverage. If I wanted to, I could put a little stack like that, a little haystack, you know? And it's just a nicer way to present. Leafy greens, you know, so you could do this to lettuce, you could do it to cilantro, you know, you could do it to any kind of leafy green. And that, so that again, chiffonade, we stack our leaves up on each other like a little stack, like playing cards, and then we roll it like a cigar. Not anything else, ultraviolet. It's a cigar. And then we chiffonade. Always have your knuckles against the blade so that you don't cut your fingies. And that's it.
Look at that. Okay, got it.
Roll up, yeah. And now we can
stack, put that. That's our roll, mise en place.
Stack, roll, cut. Chiffonade. All right, we're ready to put these steaks in, baby. Here we go.
How's everybody doing?
Let us know.
One slow down, two, keep going.
Keep it rocking. These are steaks.
Christine liked our stack roll cut method.
Stack roll cut. And if you're a vegetarian, that'll be a missed steak.
Liz said, do we need to turn the potatoes?
I mean, you can if you want. I'm going to look at mine. That's a good idea. Let's look at them. Ooh, look at these. They're so pretty. Cheese is all getting all happy. See that? You can flip them over if you want.
Ooh, they smell good.
Yeah.
Ooh, they smell good.
Yeah. Garlic, potatoes, the cheese. This is like, it's gonna be delicious with that steak. Hey, back in. All right. So my rule with proteins is you always dry them off. And if you can see these steaks, you know, they're on some parchment paper here, but they are leaking myoglobin. It's not blood, it's myoglobin. And we want to just dry them off. If you don't dry your proteins, what will happen is the moisture that is stuck to your meat will effectively boil instead of sear. So you go from, you're trying to do a dry cooking method with sear, and instead you end up doing a wet cooking method, which is boil. So, we got some nice dry steaks. And I'm gonna season those bad boys up. I'm also gonna kick on my burner to high, because we're not messing around. We want a nice sear. And I'm gonna season with Pro Seasoning, coast to coast, both sides.
Like a space ghost?
Space ghost, coast to coast. You know it. And mine are flat iron steak. So you got some marbleization. It is a steak that the butcher used to bring home. This used to be like one of those butcher's cuts. You know, and then they said, well, you know, we could probably make some money if we sold this. And so then we were lucky enough that the butcher now sells us this beautiful cut of meat called a flat iron. But it is the top blade of the chuck roast. So since a cow is a quadruped, walks on all fours, the least worked muscles are towards the back. And so that your tenderloin comes from the back, you know, the actual back of the cow. So the top of the shoulder blade, you know, could be up the chuck. It's an exercised cut, but that steak at the top, that's the chuck, and it's very tender. It eats like a steak, but it has the flavor of an exercised cut. That's what makes it so special. If you guys want to support my stream, I would love it if you guys would go to my website, chefnikki.net, and maybe get some merch, get yourself a thermometer, a cool t-shirt so that you're the coolest kid at the farmer's market. I also sell Pro Seasoning, which I don't even have a jar up here for whatever reason.
In the back.
Pro Seasoning, made by a pro so you can cook like a pro. This is my go-to all-purpose seasoning blend I've used for my entire career, and it is made with Himalayan pink salt. A little goes a long way, and it's made with good stuff.
My Shrek world says, chef, my mom says that to me all the time now after cooking classes, LOL, Nana is now mise en place enforcement.
Good, she's doing her job.
Yeah. And Ultra V said, great lesson in beef, chef, thank you.
Beef lesson.
Hashtag beef lesson.
Yeah, hashtag beef lesson.
Rhonda said, I think my steak is not much thicker than yours. I'll use my thermometer to cook, right?
Yeah, I'm going to cook mine to 125 degrees. I like them 125 degrees, then I rest them. If you want them cooked further, we're going to have some resting time. So they will cook up a little bit, you know, further. If you want it like around medium, 135 degrees, 140, five is a medium well. Well done is 155. And I won't troll you if you like it well done. I'll just leave it dangling there. Okay, wait till your pan is smoking hot.
I was just gonna say maybe you'll give them the evil eye or
yeah, you get the stink eye. But hey, man, you know what? Listen, it's at this point in life if you like a steak well done. That's fine. You know, you're just trying to make it in this world. All right, so since our pan is smoking, we're gonna go ahead and add these steaks. We never add meat to a pan that is not smoking. Oh my God, there it is, baby.
Barbie Morrow joined.
Barbie Morrow! My friend and CEO of Red Eye Coffee.
Jimmy said, I now have 3 cast iron pans.
Heck yeah.
That's the way to go. Gail wants to know what kind of oil.
I use a little olive oil, but you can use canola oil. If you have some duck fat, use some duck fat. I get this duck fat in a can like this. You can use that as well. Something with a high smoke point. And we're not going to bother them. We're just going to leave them like that.
Rhonda says, you're so awesome. I'm a better cook.
Oh, thank you. Give us the number one if Oliver is busting your eardrums. What about that frozen thing that's in there?
I don't know.
You already did it?
Mm-hmm.
He's a puppy. He's just a baby. Leave it alone.
Leave it alone.
Leave it alone. Beautiful. Nice and seared. Caramelization, that's called the Maillard reaction. That is the caramelization of proteins in the presence of sugar. And so what happens is the meat breaks down and it caramelizes. And that is something we look for as chefs. That's what you want. Look at that. Nice and brown, seared up, beautiful.
Oh, cool. It's a, Jimmy said he got cast iron pans for Father's Day.
Oh, wow.
That's a nice gift.
Yeah. Turn the fan on a little bit so the head smoke on so I can go on. That's okay. See, I usually cook over here, so I can cook over here so you can see me. Turn on my fan. All right, now I'm gonna let these finish in the oven. I gotta move the rack.
Smells good.
There it is.
Liz says, smells good.
Ooh, yeah. All right, so steak is in the oven. It's finishing. It's, you know, just a couple of minutes. It'll take, mine are kind of thin. If you got a thicker steak, it's gonna take a little bit longer. But I wanna get that meat juice all in the pan so I have a nice, beautiful fond, F-O-N-D, so that when I make my sauce, I can use those drippings as a base for my sauce. F-O-N-D, fond, is like foundation. That's the little juicy bits at the bottom of your pan when you make a protein.
Liz asks you, keep the oven at 425?
Yeah, it's fine. All right, let's plate this salad.
Salad.
Yeah. Give me number one, if you want me to slow down. Right now, the potatoes are in the oven. They're almost done. The steak is in the oven. When it's done, we're gonna make this sauce. It's gonna take us like 5 minutes to make. And so the only thing we have left is our tomato salad. So I've tried to kind of streamline these classes so that it takes less time so that you get dinner on the table. Let's see, gotta find my balsamic. Some olive oil. There it is. Okay. How we doing, guys? Nice fresh tomato salad.
I don't see a lot of ones or twos, so.
Okay. Everybody's cooking. Okay, that's cool. Okay, so we got our tomatoes, and I'll put these tomatoes in the middle. Some pro seasoning.
Ooh, that looks pretty.
Yeah. Fresh summertime salad.
Got a one and a two.
One, mixed.
Yeah.
Mixed emotions. That's okay. A little balsamic. Kind of put it at the bottom so that it doesn't tomatoes up too much. Now we got some basil. Put that right in the middle, a little on the outside, but that's our main garnish, so stack it up. There's our tomato salad.
Stop.
Look at that. Put that on the table, okay? Let everybody enjoy that. That's nice family style tomato salad. People eat with their eyes. Okay, how we doing? I'm doing great.
It smells delicious.
Thanks.
Becky wants to get your thoughts on pickles.
Yeah, Oliver's being bad, but that's always every week he's bad. Pickles. I like a pickle. Pickles are delicious. leave him out there. He might just wander in the yard and kind of stay out.
Christine wants to know: did you put oil and vinegar on the tomatoes?
Yeah, I already dressed it. Just put some oil and vinegar right on the tomatoes, pro seasoning, coast to coast, and some cheese. Well, actually, I didn't put any cheese, but we could. Nice, beautiful basil, and I'll throw some cheese on there. Why not? It's like an Italian flag. Red, white, and green. Nice and summery. It'll be a good contrast to the cream sauce for our steak, so heavy. This will kind of cut that heavy sauce. But I was thinking about doing some like a braised kale for this meal, but then I said, you know what, it's summertime. We have, you know, it's not really kale season, first of all. It's tomato season, and this would be a nice addition to the meal. So we got that rocking. Pickles. Okay, so let me know your thoughts on pickles. Becky, maybe it's, I don't know, like what to pickle or what to pickle it in, or you know, just let me know what you're thinking on that one. Pockets. I put it back in the drawer. I did not. That's okay. Put it there. Let us know how you guys are doing. Oh, here it is. I'm gonna temp out this steak. I don't think it's done, but I want to show you guys how to temp it out. So we're going to stick the thermometer in the thickest part, so go right to the center. And we are at 115, so we're just like 10 degrees away, which is really close, so we're not going to cut it. And then the next thing we'll do is we will make our sauce. So let me show you, my potatoes are done. Nice and golden. A little crispy, it's got the cheese on them. Beautiful for plating.
Okay, question.
Okay.
Liz, does red cooking wine stay in the pantry or fridge?
Once it's open, in the fridge. If it's cooking wine, like it's like low alcohol, I mean, I would put it, once it's open, it goes in the fridge.
Yeah. Okay. Rhonda says, do you sell those thermometers?
I don't sell this thermometer. I sell a different one. This one is not, waterproof. The one that I sell is waterproof. You can calibrate it. And it is on chefnikki.net, and I have free in-town delivery within the 5-mile radius of 32317. So if you live within a 5-mile radius, I will bring it to you for free. So, and you can get some pro seasoning and a really cool t-shirt and a pair of tongs. I sell these heavy-duty tongs. They're like the most mega tong. You know, they don't pinch your fingers or anything like that. You'll have these tongs for like 20 years, man. They're amazing. So, let me get my board so that we can rest these things. He's just going bananas.
Bananas. so,
sorry, my charbroil. There was a question back. I'm sorry, did you run the oil on the steak or in the pan? Sorry, I missed it. The steak went in the pan, right?
Steak went in the pan, yeah. And so a little bit of oil in the pan, then the steak right in there.
Jimmy, the white stuff on the salad is cheese.
Cheese, I put some cheese.
My Shred World, any opinion on copper pans? Do they conduct better or is that a myth?
I don't know. I've never used copper pans. I don't have enough knowledge to make a really good assessment on that. I do know that a copper bowl will help whip egg whites better. But that's all I know. Just give them that peanut butter jar.
Maybe
and open it up.
Dog?
Open it up and throw it out there. He'll love it.
Rhonda's
okay.
Your tongs are awesome.
Oh, Rhonda's got tongs. These steaks are done. And I'm gonna pull them out and let them rest on this board. Okay, look at how beautiful. Nice, beautiful. I cook these to 125 degrees and then stop. But for you, you can cook it however you like it. I like it medium rare and that's it. And now I'm gonna let them rest, put some plastic wrap and a towel on top and set them aside. Don't bother them. Now we're gonna make our sauce in our pan. Need another towel. Okay, here we go. I can actually turn my oven off because I'm done with that. Here comes our steaks, or our sauce. So I have all this, you know, stuff left in the pan that's called fond. I wanna keep that, that's all flavor. I'm gonna put my shallots right in there. And remember, if you're using your pan that was in the oven, the handle's gonna be hot, so always use a towel or something so you don't burn yourself. But check that out. Change my tools. So I know they're nice and clean. And I'm just gonna sweat these shallots and get them all caramelized looking. I have enough fat in the bottom of the pan to kind of like get them going. So that's the base of the flavor for the sauce is the drippings from the pan, from the steaks, and then the shallots, man. And they're picking up all that beautiful fond. That stuff on the bottom of the pan, they're picking it all up. You can see they're already kind of colored. You know, they're picking up the color from the fond. And there we go.
Kate says, shallots have so much flavor.
So much flavor!
Joyce says, where can we find the recipes?
Joyce. The recipes are on my Facebook page. And you'll see them there. I posted it several times. So Facebook page, Nikki Talks Food. Okay, I'm using a little Malbec.
Rhonda says she only has two shallots. Is that okay?
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah, he's being a bad boy. So Oliver is, he's a rescue dog, but he is very used to having our attention on him, which we need to figure out how to. I'm going to drop a little oil in there because these are getting a little bit dry. We got to figure out, you know, he's a quarantine dog, man. He's only 6 months old, and so he's just trying to figure out what happens when he's fine all day long. It's not like we're staring at him all day, but as soon as my attention is on the camera and I'm talking, he goes bananas because he's like, I think he just feels the energy and, you know. All right, so once my shallots reach, they're kind of caramelizing right now, I'm gonna add a cup of wine. And I'm gonna reduce this wine to what's called au sec, and I'm gonna spell that for you.
Okay,
this says, can you say how much wine and then cream, dinner plate recipe?
A cup of wine, cup of cream. Wine first, and we're reducing it au sec. Au sec. It's French for until dry. Sec, S-E-C, means dry. You'll see sometimes, you know, champagne and things like that, it'll say demi-sec or partially dry. A petit four sec is a dry petit four, like a cookie. In this case, we're gonna reduce this au sec, meaning the moisture needs to be dry. So we're gonna reduce it until we have a syrup, au sec. See that? The moisture has almost gone away. There's a syrup there. And once that syrup is there, au sec, now we add our cream. And we're gonna add a cup of cream. This is good cream. Horizon. Whole Foods. Stir it up. And we're gonna reduce it again. Classically, if like a French chef was coming in here to grade me, I would definitely be straining out all these little bits. However, this is Tallahassee, baby, and we like flavor. So I'm not straining anything out because those little bits are delicious flavor. I'm gonna switch to a whisk. I'm gonna get all the sides up and I'm gonna reduce this to what's called nappé. And if you've taken my classes before, you guys remember that nappé means that you can coat the back of a wooden spoon and draw your finger through it and it leaves a line. That's called nappé. So we've learned a couple of things tonight. The last thing we talked about was nappé, that's the thickness of the sauce. The one before that, au sec, means you're gonna reduce the wine until it's almost dry. Au sec means until dry.
Liz wants to know, how much does the wine reduce?
Until it's dry. Okay. Let it reduce to nothing, Liz.
Stacy says, do I wait until the wine is gone to add the cream?
Yes. Wait till the wine is reduced. That's dry, and then you're done. And now mine is done, and I can tell that the cream is reduced enough because I can take my finger, I can coat the back of a wooden spoon, and I can draw it through and make a line. You guys see that?
My Shred World says, looks beautiful. My husband wants wine for this meal. Oh boy.
He wants wine what?
For this meal. With this meal, I guess.
Drink, give him the rest of the bottle. I'm gonna put some pro seasoning to, you know, just kind of finish off the sauce. And then we're gonna do the third cooking technique, sauce making technique. So we learned au sec, means cook the wine until dry. We learned nappé, that means you're gonna coat the back of a wooden spoon and we can draw our finger through and make a line. The next thing we're gonna learn is mounted with butter, or monté au beurre. And that is, we're gonna finish the sauce with butter so that it has a nice sheen to it and it's rich and beautiful. So that's, you can leave it out if you want, if you're like, oh, well, there's enough fat in here. Fine, that's cool, man, but I'm gonna do it. So I added my little bit of pro seasoning to season. Always taste your food, make sure that it's got make sure that it's got enough salt and, you know, seasoning in it. And so, we are going to mount with butter. So give me a number one if you want me to slow down. Number two if you're ready for me to add the butter.
Liz said, did I miss the butter? Nope.
Not yet. It's coming. Ice cold. Needs to be ice cold.
Ice cold butter.
Ice cold butter. It's called mounted with butter. Monté au beurre. That's the last step. And that means that we are going to finish with butter, monté au beurre.
Got some ones. Jimmy's got a one. Liz has got a one.
That means slow down? Yeah, that means slow down. All right. I won't put the butter in yet. That's the last step.
What you did in the sauce.
Yeah, so the sauce, we just put the shallots into the pan. We took the steaks out, put the shallots into the pan, let them caramelize. Then we added a cup of wine, let it reduce au sec or until dry. Once it was basically dry. There's like a syrup left in there. Then we added a cup of cream, reduce that until it coats the back of a wooden spoon and I can draw my finger through and make a line. And then the last step will be monté au beurre or mounted with butter.
Jimmy said my kit was not pre-made.
It wasn't, Jimmy. But I made it so there wasn't a lot of ingredients, like, you know, easy peasy.
Gail could have won too, so.
Sorry, guys. Yeah, the meal kits are super convenient. You know, we put a lot of effort, you know, into making those kits and making them easy for you. So you just like basically take everything out and make the food. But it's very labor intensive too. You know, so you know, sorry that we don't have that right now, but. I hope you like it this way because maybe you're saving some money. Maybe you had some of these things in your pantry already, so there's like maybe less waste. I don't know, but you know, we do the best we can to kind of just navigate through this crazy time. So that's my guilt trip for you. All right, I'm going to start mounting with butter, and that is I'm using ice cold butter, and I'm basically just gonna pull it into little chips, and I want to just put a little at a time, and it's supposed to be 3 tablespoons. I'll probably end up putting 2 in there because 3 might be too much. Make sure the heat is off when you do this part. The heat must be off. The reason why is the sauce will do what's called break, and once it's broken, it's hard to get it back together. When the sauce breaks, what'll happen is the fat will push out, and it'll be like basically an oil slick. So this technique is you know, it's a little bit complicated to do, but we're gonna do it together and you guys got this. So I'm gonna do a little at a time. We already did 1 tablespoon. Now we're gonna do another tablespoon. I'm basically just kind of like busting it up with my fingers, and I'm putting a little chips of ice cold butter into the pan. My heat is completely off and I'm just basically whisking in, and that's called mounted with butter, monté au beurre. So you guys have learned some French tonight. Look at that. And that adds a nice, beautiful sheen, a nice, beautiful mouth feel. You know, butter is unmatchable, you know? It's like, you can't really replace the taste of butter. I'm gonna put the last one in, why not? So we are doing no heat. The heat must be completely off, otherwise your sauce will break. And again, we're just taking that ice cold butter and we're just chipping little pieces with our hands into the sauce and whisking it in, and it will just kind of melt together with the cream.
Question.
Monté au beurre.
Liz says, once you add the butter, do you turn the heat down?
Heat off, turn the heat off, no heat. No heat when you finish with butter. When you do mounted with butter, monté au beurre, no heat. Otherwise your sauce will break.
Ultra B says, could you throw cognac in there and flambe it up?
Yeah, you could, you know, just as a similar sauce, it's called, you know, steak au poivre has a cognac cream sauce, and it's lovely. So you sear the steak, remove the steak, flambé with cognac. The cognac actually fuses together with the leftover fat in the pan, and then you add cream, reduce that, and that is your steak au poivre sauce. So this is similar. It's a similar technique. You know, you sear the steak, finish in the pan with the booze, and add cream. But you know, this is red wine instead. All right, this is done. So we're gonna plate. Showtime, baby. All right, so I'm gonna take a couple of these logs, and you guys know I love to put starch in the center of the plate so that I use it as kind of to build height for my plate.
Rhonda wanted to know what your YouTube channel name was. It's Nikki Talks Food, Rhonda.
YouTube channel name is Nikki Talks Food. Tomorrow I have a new video it's coming out. It's on jackfruits, all about jackfruit, and I make chick-un nuggets out of the jackfruit. These spoons, I love these spoons for plating. I buy them from like Walmart. They're like $1. But these gigantic spoons are like wonderful for plating. I'll keep them in my knife kit, you know, when I work and stuff, and I just kind of use them for whatever, you know? So I have my potato logs there. I got this nice, beautiful sauce. Look at that.
Woo!
Yeah. Ultra B says, thank you, chef.
My pleasure, y'all, my pleasure. Put a little parsley. Okay, and there we go. Here is our dinner. So, let's see, we did this in an hour, okay? 1 hour. Got this beautiful steak with potatoes, summer tomato salad, and that's it, baby. Easy peasy. Let me know your thoughts. What do you guys think? I'm gonna dip a potato log in the sauce, is what I'm gonna do. Liam, you gotta try this. It's so good. Potato log in the sauce, baby. So that's it. This is our dinner. Steak beurre rouge with roasted potato logs and our beautiful tomato salad.
Okay.
Any questions?
Any questions? We have some comments.
Yeah, let's hear it.
Stacy says, thank you, Nikki. This is amazing.
Awesome.
Rhonda said, thanks. I'm looking forward to jackfruit.
Yeah, that's a good one. The fruit actually tastes like juicy fruit bubblegum. It was really weird. Jen said it smelled like feet when I was cutting it up.
Not at all.
It's a weird fruit.
It tasted fine. It's just the smell.
The smell was very strange, but yeah, and it's huge. A lot of work to get that sucker apart.
Yeah.
All right. Any other comments? That's it.
For now.
Okay.
So maybe people are still playing.
Yeah, you guys played away, and you know, we'll hang out here for a little bit. Maybe I'll eat some more potatoes. I don't know.
You guys got questions?
Questions?
Stacy says, this is so good. Emily is dying that it's so good. See you in 2 weeks. Love you.
Awesome.
Christine said, awesome. Thank you, Nikki.
Thank you, guys.
We want to know how you guys had your plates turn out, so don't forget to take pictures and post it on Nikki Talks Foods Facebook.
Take pictures. Follow my Facebook page. Also, follow my YouTube channel. Subscribe. It's free. Help keep me going and putting out good content. You know, I have my web store, chefnikki.net. You can buy all kinds of stuff on there to help support me and support the stream. Also, I listed my Venmo there. I feel kind of weird saying that, but it's there. And that would be awesome so that way I can keep going with these live streams.
Gail said, yum. And Jimmy said, oh, he has a question. Where do you buy the jackfruit at?
I bought it at Publix, Jimmy. Yeah, yeah, Publix. My Publix here on Cap Circle and Mahan they've been having jackfruit for the past like couple of months. So I'm like, I kept passing by and going, you know, I really gotta do a video on this, you know? And so I got one the other day and I let it ripen on my counter and man, I just went to work. It was so good.
Rhonda said she's gonna share the video with her friends.
Yeah, please share my videos. You can go to my YouTube channel and share my videos. The more people watch them and the more they get shared, then the more views I get and I can monetize that eventually. But I'm not at anywhere near being able to do that. So I need some support from our little community. So please share my videos from my YouTube channel. It's as easy as like clicking, copy, and then sharing on your Facebook, you know, news feed and all that kind of stuff. And I got tons of videos with all kinds of stuff where I make cheese, you know, sweet tea brine chicken tenders. I make blueberry pie, oatmeal cream pies, like all kinds of stuff. So there's some really great recipes there. So please, yeah, if the more you guys share, the more views I get and the more watch time I get, and then I can actually like monetize eventually. So that would be awesome. All right, guys. So I guess that's the end of our live stream. Don't forget to post your food pics. I can't wait to see them. Don't forget to tag me, Nikki Talks Food, on Instagram. It's Chef Nikki, and I love you guys, and I really appreciate you guys. Next week, I'm taking the week off. It's a holiday week, so I'm going to take that week off, and then we will be back the 9th. We are making shrimp and grits.
Liz says, woohoo, looks great. Thanks for everything. She's still whisking.
Okay. That's cool. Right on. Whisk away. Whisk away, Liz. You're a doll. Thanks so much. Okay.
Well, Rhonda says, good night and happy 4th.
Happy 4th, y'all. Okay, guess what I do now is what?
Me, stop the video.